the NFL to Hollywood to fatherhood. Join me as I tackle my next journey in life, becoming Hollywood's next action star. What's up, Renobs? We're gonna have a 20-minute back day blitz where I just don't stop. Unedited, uncut, unpleasant, uncool. All right, let's get to it. This is just to get a little blood in there, get a little face pull in here real quick. Yeah, this is kind of my warm up, but also a way I like to get some rear delt work. If you've been watching for any period of time, you know I do this every back day. Nothing new. Yeah. But what is new that you'll see once I get out of the way is this Mortal Kombat neon light centerpiece behind this pulley system. It's pretty rad and gives me nostalgia when I look at it, and also makes me feel the fear of Raiden because I think he's going to come fatality me. That's not true, but I did have those fears as a kid, and it's something, you know, that just sticks with you. Get over here. But Raiden did a weird, like, sideways, horizontal, rip your heart out thing or something. Anyways, come right back to the band pull aparts. Now move the hands out just an inch or so. Boom, keep going. And I'll do that a few times. Really blow up this upper back. Rear delts, and it's low intensity. Easy on the joints. It's a good way to warm up your back in general, too, before the back day. That's why I like it. So I'll just keep riggedy riffing. You better check yourself, fool, until my next run-through of what I just showed you. Here's another something I'll show you. I still have that little dangle piece in the back. Do they remove, is that what people say when you get your tonsils removed, you lose your dangle? Or is that a really dumb thing that I just said that I shouldn't have said because now you know how dumb I am? Hit me below and let me know. It's already out there, so I'd like to know. I mean, it's a Google away, but I'd rather somebody else tell me, so I don't have to spend the time doing it. Yahtzee. Tell me something good.
I like it.
Mortal Kombat. Sub-Zero. Wins. Okay. That's about all right. That's good. I don't know why, but I was getting a good burn even in my lateral delts. Something's taken over that shouldn't be. I don't know why I showed you both sides. I said delts. You got the picture. All right, let's go to some pull downs. This is a prime attachment. Got it from my father-in-law for Christmas. That's really all I had on that. No, it's good. It's got a lot of free movement within it, so it's like more narrow at the top, and I pull it. It's pretty rad. I don't want to explain it. I'm just going to go do it. The reason I really like it is the reason I like pretty much most exercises that I do. It's that I feel like I'm getting a really good contraction out of it. Like a good contraction for me is when I get to that bottom piece, when I feel it the whole way through, I feel it working that muscle. You know, you not only get the burn in that muscle, but like on that bottom pull piece, it's like I get a little of a pinch, you know, like a pinch. I can really, really contract it at the bottom piece. You get a great pump. You get good strength gains, muscle growth over time. Those are things to look for, you know, how your body responds and what movements you fall best into. Da-na-na-na-na. I forget the name of this song. I went to Pearl Jam Radio from Even Flow. Even Flow. But I'm not feeling the radio as much. It's not related enough to the feeling I wanted from Pearl Jam. So maybe I'll try a different Pearl Jam. Alive. I want to feel alive right now. Go to radio. Oh, yes. All the way up. Boom. That bottom piece, I'm really getting a good contraction. Kind of a pinch in there. Oh, yeah. Yeah. You know what? Brain got hijacked by Pearl Jam again. Just thinking maybe I'll superset low row with the pull down for the sake of time and for the sake of you not having to hear me jabber and sing between sets. I'll just keep moving, you know? No, no, and I'll tell you why it's no. I have to go heavier on the low row, and I don't want to have to do that between each set. You know what I'm saying? I think you do. Oh, yeah. Woo. So today, finally had a day where I didn't have to do any real audition prep. And we had a sitter for 5 hours, and I thought, as much as I don't want to do this, it'd be really nice to clear it out and not have to think about it for the rest of the year. It was all the tax prep stuff, the rest that I had not previously finished. And got the rest of that pretty much knocked out. So that didn't feel good, but it feels good now. It's kind of like moving, you know? It's the worst thing in the world, but there's light at the end of the tunnel, and then it's awesome when you're in your new place. And hence why I don't have a ton of time to work out today. Maybe that's one of the things that you'll see me get better at throughout the year, my time management, because that seems to always be the case. I don't have much time to work out. Anyways, I already feel a little lighter getting that. I guess they call it eat the frog. Do the hardest thing first and then do the rest later. There's more depth to that that I am not able to fully get out of my mouth. What was I saying? Something? That was frogs. Yeah, I've started to hear those more lately in my backyard. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, hitting the wall. Don't you do it, you coward. Ugh. Yeah. Ugh, come on. Ugh. Ah. Oof.
The baddest mofo.
Probably couldn't hear me.
Little Casey Jones action.
I met Elias Cotillas once. Told him, dude, I had your action figure growing up. You were my favesies on Ninja Turtles 1. And he was super kind and cool. And he's like, you know what? I loved the action figure too, but they actually kind of made it to look like someone more like you and not so much what I looked like. Which was super nice of him to say, but he killed that role, man. There's no other Casey Jones in my eyes. Woo! I'm gonna move fast, just pump them. Yeah. Oh man. Golly. Oh, okay, that's good. All right, move the bench out. Hit this low roll. And although it's a hassle, I really like this attachment even for the low row, so I'm gonna give it a go. I gotta put like a plate down. Oh, I can pull this little extender out where my feet go, and then I still got to put like a 45 pound plate there so I can really stretch it. Otherwise it just, you know, hits the bottom. You get a less of a range of motion. Oh, forgot I declined that bench. Forget you saw me do that. Today's again, more of a pumper because obviously I'm not taking long rest sets because I don't have as much time. So I'm just trying to, you know, I'm still going to taking everything to failure and beyond where basically I can't get the full rep, keep going, even less of a partial. And anyhow, yeah, so clearly today I'll get, you know, a good pump. You know, I'll be breathing heavier, maybe burn some more calories, but I won't get the same kind of strength stimulus because I'm not resting fully between these sets. I'm not fully recovered, you know, and a lot of those sets I was getting, you know, 5 or 6 instead of what should be over 10 if I was fully recovered. Or 10 or more, something like that. So here we go with the low row. And that's it. Just here we go with the low row. You know what I'm saying? You definitely do, because that was a very simple statement. So I've been told I'm a simple guy. And, you know, some people say that in a good way, as if, like, it doesn't take much to please you, which is maybe also true. But I think they mean it like simple Jack. You know what I'm saying? I learned to say things like, you know what I'm saying, to fill space and to sound like I know what I'm saying, but I don't. But you know what I'm saying. I put that on backwards. No, I think I can rectify that. I think I can rectify that. Well, yeah. Oh, I took the weight off. What a dope. Dude, freaking hate this small space to get these plates in. Sometimes it is a hassle and a half. Oh, I want to hurt it, cuss at it. Oh yeah, here we go. Okay, well, that's still, it's kind of hitting my shoes, whatever. Yeah. Yeah, come on. So, that didn't go as planned necessarily. I thought it would feel a little bit better getting a little more space between my feet and that feet platform thing. But it didn't, because all the pressure was just on my heels, which you can see over here. And it made it weird to balance. And by weird, I mean awkward. Felt really awkward. So let's do another one. Come on. Taking her hand, find my peace of mind. I'm gonna give you some of my good time. Oh man, with a weird sharp pain in my thumb muscle, now it's dull. Speaking of dull, here I am again. My face, anyhow. I'm gonna take a little weight off that because it felt a little heavy on that one.
He ain't heavy. He's my brother, baby.
Yeah.
Dang it.
Man, that was more awkward than it needed to be, that lift. Not only was I having to balance on a low surface area on that plate, so it was just my heels, and they were also tilted at an angle because of the circular plate, but I jammed my elbow on there a couple times, so that I'm trying to lift my elbow up on every rep. But that's where the back workout landed for the day. How long have I been running this take here? I don't think it tells me that on here. Oh well, not long, tell you that much. And I'm just about done. Sometimes it's better to get something in than nothing. That's what today is. I got family upstairs waiting for me, preparing a meal. Not just my immediate family, my sister and her family are over, so I'm all pumped up mentally and physically. I'm gonna go in there and layer some muscle over, some protein over this muscle, build a little muscle, build a little relational bonding with the family, have a good time. Although, I think I'm gonna pump these arms up a little bit too, just with a little something, you know, just dust them a little bit. It's my body, my choice. Mm. It's good. I'll leave a couple in the tank for tomorrow. I want to try something. This may be a terrible idea, but it's in my head it says it might be something cool. So, is this a thing to take two single pulleys on the same hook? Kind of. I mean, it's definitely working my triceps. Especially trying to like really separate them on the bottom, move the handles as far away from each other as you can. Innovation comes from constraints. Little time. Let's throw together something that might save time instead of doing single arm pulleys. Do two at once. It's working. The ancient Egyptians knew that. They had a lot of constraints and they made the pyramids. They did it so well, and a lot of people think it was aliens because they still don't know how they did it. Just can't give the human enough credit, you know? Has to be aliens because you can't figure it out. That's like the whole YouTube Natty or Not thing, right? It's a bunch of dudes that aren't okay with other people being big unless they took steroids because that makes them feel a little better about it. So I have to be an alien. I can't just be a buff dude. You know, without this piece. Wow. Come on, baby. That's it. That's it. What are you becoming? Where are you starting at? Where are you trying to go? Just take one step every day. Get a little bit closer, a little bit closer. Some days it will be like this. Some days it'll be, you just barely made it. And those are the days sometimes you feel like you want to quit. And it takes everything just to go through the motions. But you went like this on that day instead of going 9 steps backwards. Because one day rolls over into 2, into 3, into a week, into the mindset of, no, I'm going to get everything in order. I'm going to get all this stuff out of the way. And then I'm going to hit it hard. And then you get the cold and then you delay it more. And you lose your gains. Just keep pressing forward. You'd be shocked what the compound effect can do for your life. Get after it.